E! Entertainment Television is giving radio one hell of a facelift. Ladies and gentlemen, Howard Stern. On the air, behind the mic.
Of course I'm wonderful.
You've never seen radio like this before.
I give you a reason to live.
Howard Stern, Monday through Saturday, 8 and 11 Eastern and Pacific. It's the best radio on television. E! Entertainment Television.
Let me take a few phone calls this morning, see how our audience is doing. I have a few things to read to you. I must tell you, we've gotten a lot of faxes and different things this morning, news articles and such that I must share with you. Let's go right to Albany. Albany, you're on the air. I'll just go to all of our cities. Albany, you're on the air.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, baby.
Oh, this is Howard. I'm sorry.
Well, don't be sorry. I mean, just lower your radio. Everybody who's calling us, lower the radio.
I did. First, I want to say I got your video, and it's great.
Thank you.
And your poster is beautiful.
Thanks. And by the way, you can see the poster right behind Robin on our e-show on television. You know, it's funny. A woman calls the other day, goes, where did Robin get that poster of Howard that is behind her on the E! Show?
Where did I get it?
Yeah. Now, I've been screaming about this thing for, I don't know, a couple of months already, telling people, order 1-800-52-STERN. I'm reading in the paper yesterday. I'm looking in the classified section. A guy is selling, listen to this, our old tape, Butt Bongo Fiesta, and our CD collection of Crucified by the FCC, and U.S. Open Source. Those three things for $1,200.
Whoa.
He got $1,200 for it. And I'm sitting there going, a lot of our fans have not ordered the new tape. They haven't. They haven't ordered the poster. They don't know what this stuff is. And then when they get it, everyone really loves it.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I was reading on the Prodigy computer service. Everyone was writing back to each other, did you get it? The tape is really good.
You're really into that Prodigy thing.
I check it now. I look at it. I like to see what people are saying about me.
I'm on Prodigy.
Are you?
Yes. And you've written, talked about one of my messages, and I was very pleased.
Yeah, I got home after Letterman. I quickly turned it on to see how I did on Letterman, and the reviews were very positive, and I went, oh, good. Because I was just feeling like, you know. I was feeling weird after I did the Letterman show. It was just very weird. What is with our phone connection here? Hi, you're on the air in Philadelphia.
Hi, how you doing?
Good.
Is Howard there?
Yes.
Wait a minute, we'll go get him.
Hold on. Here he is. Hi, I'm on the air.
Howard.
Lower your radio.
I have it down.
Yeah, no, you don't. You're lying.
No, I just turned it down.
I hear it.
I swear it's down. Hey.
Maybe that's just people talking in the background.
I came up the other day to try and get on the Letterman show.
Yeah.
And,
Sir, you have some kind of something going on in the background.
Okay, it's the TV, I'm sorry.
Oh, so you're going to make a guessing game out of it?
No.
In other words, I said radio, so therefore you're allowed to have other forms of media on. You're a confused moron. That's what you sound like. You sound like a dope.
I was trying to keep up with the
odds? What are the odds of getting through to this radio show? Finally getting, you've been waiting to get through. I finally take phone calls. You finally get through. And now you got to have a television set on in the background competing with you.
Well,
for goodness sake. Would you do me a favor and hit yourself in the head with your own phone?
Yeah, hold on.
Go ahead.
How's that?
Good.
Your head sounds rather empty.
That's the same sound Fafa Fooey's head had when I had him hit himself with the phone.
Okay.
Yes, go ahead, genius.
Okay. I came up the other day to New York to try and get on the Letterman show.
No, you didn't want to be on the Letterman show.
I mean,
you wanted to be in the audience.
Right. And there were some black guys out on the street protesting. Saying that they were the real Jews. They're protesting against whites and Jews.
Yeah, they're out there all the time, not in front of Letterman. They're out on the streets of New York all the time. There's this group of black guys. I don't know what they call themselves.
They call themselves the Black Israelites.
Yeah, that's it. Robin got stopped by them the other day. They were yelling at her.
Oh, they were hysterical.
Yeah, they're these black guys who claim they're the original Jews. Now, you could never...
They don't even call themselves black people.
Right, they're Jews. And the thing is, if this is your agenda... To stand out on the street and scream at people that you're Jews.
Who ever heard of Jews doing that?
Yeah, who cares? Why would you? Most Jews try to keep it a secret that they're Jews.
They're not broadcasting.
It is the strangest agenda I have ever seen. And they even have their own TV shows and stuff.
Yeah.
On the local cable channels here.
And all they do is, even on television, they scream.
And why are they screaming? So let's assume they're black Jews. What is the problem?
Well, they scream at black people that they don't know who they are and that they're going to go to hell because of it. and that they're just dying, and then they scream at white people that they're devils or something.
Oh. Well, what were they yelling at you about?
Well, because I work with you. You're the devil, and you're sending me to hell, is what they were saying. That white man is going to send you to hell.
Yeah, they were really coming on heavy with Robin. Really heavy.
Yeah, because they have these megaphones, and they yelled at me for two blocks.
Yeah, it's pretty wild.
Did you get to talk to John Mellencamp the other night?
No, I got to tell you, I'm backstage at Letterman.
Oh, did you see anybody backstage?
No. You're backstage at Letterman, and I sit back there in the dressing room, and I don't see Mellencamp. Mellencamp, Gary went downstairs to watch Mellencamp set up. Mm-hmm. Baba Booey came with me. And Mellencamp is out there, John Cougar Mellencamp.
And, John Cougar Mellencamp, you moron.
No, no, no. I'm making an inside joke, you jackass. Don't you ever call me a moron, I'll hang up on you. Jackie's middle name is Cougar. If you knew anything about the show, you big stupid idiot. You sit there every day for 4 hours and you don't know that?
Nitwit.
All right, I'll give you a test. What's Fred's middle name?
D. Snyder.
Wrong. Herpes. All right. Frederick Herpes right. Norris.
You're crazy.
That's right. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, so Baba Booey goes downstairs, and Mellencamp is screaming during the sound check.
Oh, yeah?
He's like, hey, man, we got to do background vocals here, man, and I don't care. I don't care how loud the music is. I don't even want to hear my own voice. I want the music to drown out my voice. And on the background vocals, if they're off key, don't you guys have a special piece of equipment that can speed up the background vocals and put them into the right pitch?
Wow.
Evidently, he was throwing a real tizzy. He's got a real little man complex. He's a tiny little guy.
Uh-huh.
Because he stood next to Letterman, and he was like 3 inches tall.
He's like Letterman's waist.
He's like Thumbelina. The guy was like yelling and all upset. He was so upset he added another name onto his name. John Cougar Mellencamp Diarrhea. We got to take a break. I'll come back right after these words. I was busy computing this weekend.
Yes, what did you compute?
I was writing down some stuff for my movie. And
how's that going now? Are you...
Real good.
You sent the guys back to flesh out what you did on that weekend?
Yeah, they put together a really good outline.
Yeah?
Yeah, we took segments of the book, put it in order, how we want to shoot and stuff, and now you got to write the script.
You know how you want to shoot, but you don't know what to shoot.
No, we know what to shoot. You got to put it in script form now.
That's what I'm saying. You don't know exactly what you're shooting because you got to write the script.
Right. We know the scenes we want to hit.
I see. You got to write the transition.
Right. And we know what order we want the scenes to occur in.
Okay. Now, you're not shooting the movie in sequence, are you?
No. Who knows? Yes. No. It's going to be cool, though. Because my sister comes over yesterday and she goes, what's going on with your movie?
Yeah.
You know, and on weekends, I hate to talk business because, you know, it's a pain in the ass. But it's my sister, so I try to treat her right, unlike Barbara Streisand.
So you go along with this even though you're perturbed?
Yeah. I said, oh, we're working on it, you know. She goes, oh, yeah, am I in it yet? I go, you know, as a matter of fact, you're not.
And you don't think she's going to be, did you?
Yeah, I did. And she goes, it figures. You act like I never grew up in the house. I go, hey. She goes, what about the time I locked you in the closet? I go, you know, that is funny. Maybe I will put that in. You know what? Maybe I will. We'll see. We'll see.
Yeah, that's a story I don't know.
Yeah. I was writing all the dream girl sequences.
She's not in those?
No. My sister is not my dream girl. It's pretty cool, though. I was on the computer. That IBM is some company. I'm going to plug them. Because I had them put there. I think they're better than Apple. You see, can I give you a lecture on computers?
Certainly.
What's killing everyone is this Windows. Windows sucks.
Why is it everybody has to go to Windows?
They don't know that OS 2 is out there. Apple has their own thing going, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then people who own IBM compatibles or IBMs end up going to this Microsoft Windows. They buy a program that's called Windows.
Right.
It kind of looks like Apple a little bit. But they have a thing called OS 2 where you can actually open up 900 different windows and work. I was had my CD player on from my computer. I was controlling it from my computer while I was typing in notes for the movie. At the same time, I had another window open that I typed notes in for the radio show. At the same time, I had another window open where I was installing Fafafui pictures into the computer. So there were 100 things going on
now,
while...
What do you mean you were controlling the CD from the computer?
I have a... When I press my CD... Here, I'll show you. I can even do it on my laptop. Hold on. Here, I'll show you. Let me give you a demonstration. Okay, can the camera get this? Can you guys get my laptop? I guess they're getting it. See, Robin, what I can do is pull up a CD player.
Mm-hmm.
See, I got a whole bunch of programs in here. And here, for example, is the CD player. See, it's marked compact disc.
Okay.
I just double-click on that. I can close this up at the same time. And up comes... See, now, I don't have my CD attached to my laptop right now, so it says the CD device is currently unavailable. I'm not, you know...
Right, you're not plugged in.
But what would come up is a little CD player. It's a little tiny CD player. It's like it looks like a CD player, and you can press play, and your CDs play through it. And you can control the volume and everything.
And you could, reprogram your CD player?
Yeah.
To play tracks out of sequence?
Sure.
And things like that?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, wonderful.
Then, for example, well, I've shown you this, what I do on the show. Here, I'll plug this in. Right out of this little thing. I think this is kind of interesting. I can play sounds right off this. See this here?
Mm-hmm.
Well, any sound effect we use on the show, I got right here.
Oi, oi, oi.
There it is. And here's Robin laughing. Here's Baba Booey.
Baba Booey. Baba Booey.
Here's Hey Now.
Hey Now!
I put a song in here I gotta find. Remember I played it for you the other day?
Which song?
Oh, here it is.
Oh, I haven't heard this one.
Yeah. Ooh. Bang, bang, bang. Do it.
Ooh. Oi, oi, oi. Filthy.
Ooh. Come on, it's funny.
There it is. See, that's all in my computer.
I had a question about the opening of the show this morning. Fred was playing some song and there were those, in it. Now, is that Terry Hatcher?
Yes.
Okay.
That was Terry Hatcher he played this morning from Superman.
Terry Hatcher mix,
that's
okay.
Cool. But anyway, so I definitely recommend the IBM over the Apple. I've done an exhaustive study on this. But you got to get OS 2 environment, not Windows. That's where everyone's making the mistake, getting Windows.
I see.
Windows suck. It's not good. It's a toy. Say, what do you think of that, what I just said?
But with OS 2, you've got to tell people there's no more DOS. You get out of DOS.
It's DOS-based. There is a DOS underneath it.
Yeah.
But you never see it.
Okay.
Once you install it, everything's little pictures and drawings and all that.
So you don't have any more of that command crap going on.
Right. That's my computer class for today.
Thank you very much, Professor.
I'm very impressed with it because I was doing all these things and I go, now this is brilliant. Then I called up a friend of mine and I wrote to him as he wrote back to me.
Like email or something?
No email.
No.
It's called, it's a new thing IBM just put out. Don't forget, I can also dictate to my computer 50 words a minute.
But you have to talk real slow, right?
No, you talk like this.
That's not conversation.
That's 50 words a minute. No, you can't talk like this. You must talk like this. Then they got this program where I can play video to my friend and he can play video back to me.
Okay.
Over the phone line.
All right.
So we were doing that.
Now, who is this friend?
This guy named Eddie that I know.
Where is he? Next door?
No, he's in Queens. If he was in Alaska, I could still make the same phone call.
Yeah, but you're always calling. You know, you have driven down the street when you were first introduced to the car phone, talking to the person in the car next to you.
No, you know what it is? We're testing the equipment because you know what I want to do. I want to be able to see the e-show while they're editing it on my computer.
Okay.
So that
has a practical purpose.
Yeah, of course.
No longer your gameplay.
No gameplay, Robin. I don't have time for games. I'm a busy man.
Thank you.
I wear many hats. Where are my hats? Bring in all my hats. even told you what I'm going to do on vacation.
No, you sort of glossed over it like you got a big secret.
No, I don't. My wife and I decided we're going to go see some movies.
So you're not going away?
No. No, I'll tell you why I'm not going away. I was supposed to go away, and then I decided not to because I'm communicating with the guy who's writing my movie every day.
Yeah.
We're doing that every day, and we fax each other every day.
Well, that's why they made the laptop.
Laptop.
Yeah, but, you know, when you go away on vacation, you're not in a work mode. And also, I have to finish the paperback for Simon & Schuster. In fact, out in the hall, I was just out there looking at photographs of more models.
More?
With the art director. And that's a lot of work.
So tough, your job.
Yeah. And then, hey, you write a book, there should be some perks.
Always looking for the perks. You find out the perks before you sign a deal. Tell the truth.
That's true. And then also, I want to work a little with the E people over vacation, talk about, you know, editing of the show and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I have some thoughts on it. So there's lots of work to be done. And plus, I want to see some movies. I haven't seen a movie in 2 years.
Well, not in the theater.
Right. I always see them a year after they come out on video.
Yes, you're just starting to rave about The Fugitive.
Yeah. Fugitive, good movie. Oh, yeah, I saw it 2 years ago. Oh, really? I always see, I'm like most of America, I see the movies when they come out on video. Most of America sees it because they have kids and they never get out of the house.
Is that what most of America is doing?
Yep. That's why video sales are through the roof. Video rentals.
Yeah.
Never get to go to the movies. Over vacation, I'll just, you know, be normal. It should be nice.
Well, then, good. Go see Forrest Gump. I'd like to know your opinion.
I heard it was good.
Very good movie.
Yeah, you saw it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard it was real good. What is it? Tom Hanks play a retard in that?
He plays a guy with an IQ of about 75, yeah.
Well, good. I can relate.
You'll enjoy it. You'll be able to understand exactly.
Hey, that's what I'm playing in my movie. I should go see that to take some tips. I'm playing a guy with an IQ of about 75.
I know you'll come away from this movie saying you could have done this part.
Yeah, I know. I've already seen the commercials and said that. Hey,
as soon
how
as
you
I
doing?
Saw it, I said, this is another Daniel Day-Lewis.
I think I'm making a mistake in my movie, not playing a retard.
You're playing a way too sophisticated
I am.
Character.
I am. I'm playing me. I have an IQ of 86. No, but the thing is that I am really good at playing handicapped people.
Yeah.
You know that. Mm-hmm. I'm good at it. That one that De Niro played with Robin Williams.
Right, the Awakening character.
The Awakening. Hey, we got a camera in here. I can do that right now. Here's my impression of Robert De Niro in The Awakening.
Hey, I forget my name. Where am I?
Yeah. These are your greatest roles. Now Daniel Day-Lewis in My Left Foot.
All right. Hey. Yeah.
Elephant Man, you want to see that one?
Go ahead. These are your roles.
All right, what else?
You said you're going to try to play a guy.
I know, it's so stupid. And Forrest Gump, here he is.
No, you better see Forrest Gump before, because he doesn't do that.
Yeah, he might as well.
But Rain Man, there's another
All
one.
Right. One. You know, there's a noise that guys make that women can't.
Which is?
This noise right here. I'm going to show you. I've got to take my jacket off for it, though.
All right. Is that underarm thing?
Yeah.
I don't know that women can't make that noise.
Go ahead. Let me see you do it.
They just don't want to.
Let's see you do it.
I don't know how.
I can do it without moving my arm.
How do you do it?
This is where you put your hand under your arm and you make the noise like this with your arm or...
You're not doing that with your mouth.
No. Pretty good. Let me see you do it.
You just lay your hand under your arm.
Hey, go ahead and try. Yeah, put your hand under your arm.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. I'll bet you. Fred, let me see you do it.
I don't know if I can. I'll be honest.
I bet you Billy can. Can you do it, Billy?
No, Billy can. Well, no.
No, he can't do it either.
What are you, a woman?
My hand smells like Arid.
Every other, see, not every guy can do it.
Robin's armpit might be too hairy. She doesn't like to shave. Try it. Isn't that great? All right, we got to take a break. I can fart from any orifice. That's years of school.
I think that you start doing that as a child.
Yeah, and I've been doing that since I'm like
you
five.
You continue to practice. Girls just don't do,
do
that.
Do you know I can do it with my leg?
What are you talking about with your leg? Under okay. your knee?
Watch this. I have to take my pants off for it, though. Yeah, watch this. I'll do it with my leg.
Turn from the camera. Now, you're doing this under your knee?
Under my knee. Any guy who I knew who couldn't do this was a social outcast. Here, I don't know if I can do it with my pants on like this, but I'll try. Wait. It's kind of hard getting them up. That's the kind of stuff that I know how to do. For God's sake. I spent a lot of time alone in my room. I wasn't a ladies' man.
I was going to say, some guys can sit down and play a little tune in the piano.
You know how some guys...
You can make noise under your arm.
See you tomorrow.